Hello Malaysia, good morning. This is Jericho here and this is a Wait a Minute production. Today is the 20th of December 2013. It's around 11 a.m. So I'm in Kampar now and there's a lake there. That's a lake and that's not a sungai. I thought it was a river but it's actually a lake. It was informed to me by this guy named Renji, which I'm going to talk about later. So this is what Kampar actually looks like. There's a wet market or morning market happening now next to this Medan Selera, which I always come to all the time. So you can see Kampar is quite near a hill, which looks quite awesome up there. Very awesome indeed. We'll take a look up there. There's some brown bits of rock around there. That's the brown bits. So Kampar is quite a small place. Very small place indeed. So this is the Medan Selera Kampar, as you can see there. Medan Selera Kampar. So there's a last time I tried already the fish ball noodles here. So this time I'm going to try char kway teow, which is very strange to eat something that spicy or not something that heaty and also that hot in the morning. But it's now 11 a.m. and definitely it's almost lunch already. So let's get on cracking. So for sure I'm going to this uncle here is making some char kway teow. Ai xì đâu hỏi dính đó lên mua à? À mua mình đây. Ê, quay xinh à?
Xinh chong à?
Chong à, lê long quay chong à?
Lê có chong quá, có mày.
Ồ, lê mày à, lê phong à, xấu đi à mày?
Ồ.
Mày yêu xinh chong à?
Ồ.
Xinh chong à? Chủ chức ý lỗi à, thầy?
Hả?
Chủ chức ý lỗi à?
Chủ chức ý lỗi à? À. Bắt chủ chức ý lỗi mình đây.
Ủa, lúc sắp viên à? Cảm ơn lê à, lúc sắp viên, lê lúc sắp xây ở mẹ? Lúc sắp
Oh,
that's the Saigo Sea. Oh,
okay.
So, this one is a char kway teow, and you see there are a lot of eggs here. So, it is one of the ingredients to make the char kway teow. And also, this one here is the chives. Sorry, that's not chives. It's. It is chives. Chives has a distinctive herbal taste to it. It's very nice to actually cook the chives with egg as well. I mean scrambled egg or whatever. How do you actually do it? Do chives with egg this? You put the egg inside the wall, then before it is solidified by the heat, just put the chives, and or you can crack a couple of eggs into a bowl and put the chives in and put your seasoning like say salt and pepper and whatnot, and fry the egg. That's chives and eggs. And we can see that there is the cockles there. Cockles is also a very important part of the char kway teow, but some people do not like to use or eat char kway teow with cockles because they say the cockles is a bit dirty, they suck all the poison, so it's not so good. But it gives it a type of taste, distinctive taste to the char kway teow. And that is the hor fun or kway teow, which is oil and whatnot. So, besides here, they have other stuff as well. A lot of traditional Chinese foods around this area. So, let's see. The Chinese one, let's take a look here. So, they also have this type of... So if I'm not mistaken, the fish balls is right about that way there. That's the fish ball that I did a video on. And there's also something that I wanted to try, the pulut curry sauce. So there they have some kind of Pizza Hut promotion around here. And the lake is that way. So there are a lot of stalls here and some of them are quite famous. I mean famous in terms of a lot of people coming here to eat just for that traditional Chinese food. In KL and also in Ipoh, you can't get this type of traditional food. I mean, you can get char kway teow or whatever, but in KL or Ipoh, it has been bastardized by whatever that can be bastardized with. Hey, can you make me a char kway teow?
Here
to eat.
Ipoh.
So this is, he's using charcoal instead of the gas, and that's those charcoal bits. So he has to fry it and keep the heat as high as possible to make it even more delicious. Some people say that the fire must be very very hot when it comes to frying the kway teow. And he's now doing it traditionally, bungkus or tapau or takeaway. You can see the green bit there, that's the banana leaf. So the banana leaf with the heat of the char kway teow would give it a sweet aromatic taste. And I'm quite sad, she's putting the chili sauce. So chili is great with char kway teow. I'm quite sad that say in Ipoh or KL, instead of using the banana leaf, they are using plastic, which sucks ass. Because plastic with high heat is not good for health at all. And everybody was using the polystyrene food containers for your assorted rice. Bear in mind, you are eating microscopic levels of polystyrene every time you use those things. So yeah, if you can't see it, I mean, it's the same analogy with God. You believe in God or not, it's up to you, but if you can't see the polystyrene, that does not mean it's not there. So it's in a microscopic level. The same thing with God. Maybe he's there, maybe he's not, even though you don't see him. So we're going to put the bean sprouts last, because we want the bean sprouts to be as crunchy as possible. That's the best part. Crunchy bean sprouts. If you put it during or in the middle of the cooking process, the bean sprouts might be a bit too soft. So besides that, they have ji yao zha, or as in lard. That one is the brown part is lard. This ji yao zha is my
one.
Chun tou yao.
Oh,
okay, that's a mixture of lard, crackling, and also fried shallots or onions. And you lard chiu, man.
Oh, lard
chiu. You what? Yao. Yao. Chi yao. Oh, you leh? Bak yao. This is the black soya sauce. I think it's sweet or can be salty. That's the oil, the lard that gives it a nice, lovely taste. Anything that is cooked with pork, lard, or pork bones or meat, it has a very delicious taste to it. So this one is a meal for anybody who wants to eat meat instead of the usual kway teow. So the wok is a bit small as well. So when it comes to cooking cockles, it's at the end of the cooking process, because people prefer their cockles to be raw, and that's why some people, they don't like to eat cockles, because raw cockles can actually invite trouble, especially the dirty types of cockles can spread like hepatitis. I don't know which alphabet it was. How many types of hepatitis? A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z. Last time when I was small, I did not like to eat cockles at all, but nowadays I don't give. Hey, actually quite nice, the girl with the purple hair. I don't know, I see the body quite nice, but I didn't see the face. But the body is fine. Very nice. Come on, look here, I want to see your face. Ah, what the So it's a nice day. Look at the hills there, it's like hugging the hill.
Hãy subscribe cho kênh Ghiền Mì Gõ để không bỏ lỡ những video hấp dẫn.
better ask him. Hey, 幾時退休啊?
退休啊?
啊?
未知啊, 做得就做住先啦。
哦,
做得就做啦。
哦,
做得啦。 喂?
可以做得20年啊?
20年都行不行啊?
啊, 行不行啊?
可以做得兩三年的。
喂? 啊, 兩三年的啊?
啊, 啊, Asim whether he's going to retire soon since he looks so old, so he says yeah, can go on and on more than like 5 years or whatnot. Have you tried this one here? No. So this one is the traditional char kway teow. They're sitting on a stool. Normally they don't sit on a stool. If you look there, there's another char kway teow with the big extractor fan, because if you cook with high heat, you're bound to make a lot of smoke. And that's the char kway teow as well. The chap there standing up, that's the normal way of cooking char kway teow. When I say normal way, what I meant is the usual way that they are cooking char kway teow nowadays. But this uncle here is doing it the two way, sitting on the bamboo stool. That's the old way. So it's keeping alive the tradition. Back to, say, 20 or 30 years ago, I think most char kway teow sellers, they like this, using charcoal and also a bamboo stool. So this is how we put the char kway teow in and put some soya sauce into it as well. Oh, it's going to be a very long program, just following this Uncle Leong here. There's no sign. Hey, you have chiu pai? Chiu pai, I don't know. Chiu pai. Chiu pai. Never chiu pai. Oh, been stolen your chiu pai. Okay. So, okay. So I was telling him, hey, how? Oh, let's see. 你最出名唔使招牌啊，係咪？哇！你喺度等咗好耐咗咯。哇！OK。So I was telling to Uncle Leong here that he does not have a sign at all, so I was egging him. Okay. So I was egging him that okay. So I was egging him that that he's too famous already. He does not need the sign at all. Huh? Oh, hello. So is it a second generation? I'm not sure. Oh, you want to take a picture? Oh, you want to take a picture? The mother is the one who passed down the skills to him. Hey, your mother, what's your name? Yip Chiu Yong. You, sir? John Kun
Sing.
Your name is John Kun Sing. So the chef here is his name is Mr. John Kun Sing. So he put a bit of charcoal into, like, say, to heat it up.
呢度仲有咩好好食啊？
咩好食噶？
啊？啊？
唔好开档。
咩嘢？
鸡翅粉咯。
鸡翅沙河粉。我喺嗰边啊，好食啊。雲吞麵啊，好食啊，真係。好多人叫係咪 ？So he says that the wonton mee here, or this one is it says 45 stall number 45 here, which is just next year. It says the wonton mee is nice as well. Okay.
So the 32 stall.
30啊？
32 stall
我哋。Oh, this one is the stall number 32. I didn't see the sign.
名不係嘥。
Oh, so it's the stall 32. Even though they don't have a sign there. So it says, she says wonton mee is nice and gai si sao fen. Gai si sao fen means it's shredded chicken noodles with char kway teow. Oh, gai si sao fen, yau yi bo ge gong ho sik mo a? Ai old town.
Oh, ma, nei sik gong zi la.
Tiem tiem ma, go go tong, am I yong? Tam do a.
Oh,
okay. Yau hui go yi bo ge la. So I was asking her whether the gai si sao fen is it as delicious as the one in Ipoh Old Town, which I, in my opinion, is one of the greatest gai si sao fen ever made because of the soup, which is been boiled in prawn shells for a long time, is extremely sweet and very addictive, as if they put in some heroin into it. Now, that's if you're ever in Ipoh, you just go to Old Town there. Around Jalan BJ Timah, and there are a few restaurants. I forgot the name of that restaurant already, which has that Ipoh famous gai si sao fen. But you will ask around in that area, Old Town Ipoh area, Jalan BJ Timah there. Definitely, it will be a lot of people will know of the place. That place, one of the stores is famous for their gai si sao fen. Yêu chỉ nhớ mẹ hữu gì à?
Mẹ hữu gì à?
Ô xí ô xí dô gô gô mẹ yu đàn phân ô hai gô bên. Ô ok à? Ok 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 ok
ok
ok ok ok ok ok ok ok ok ok ok ok ok ok ok ok ok ok ok
ok
ok ok ok
ok
ok ok
ok
ok ok ok ok鱼蛋粉、
鸡丝河粉、
鸡丝喺边度啊？鸡丝沙河粉，
喺六金嘅六金嘅嗰度。
哦，嗰个啊，我今日又开啦。
有。
Okay, so that one the store there is 鸡丝沙河粉 maybe next time 啦。诶，仲有个咩布鲁咧？布鲁布鲁同埋咖喱汁啊？你用布鲁冇？
咖喱汁，
嗰個點心啊，用嗰啲米啊，叫咩？
點心啊，叫糯米飯啊。
啊，糯米飯有咖喱汁噶，喺邊度啊？
喺埋呢度咪有咯，
係咪好出名啊？
哦，咧就係好多人買噶。
嗰邊啊？
哦，咧就呢度啫嘛。
有開係咪？
個風扇嗰度啊。
哦，風扇係嗰個。哦，所以我哋 check it out and see which store it is. So there's another one recommended by this Motor Mouth from Ipoh. So today is not open, which this one is store number 42 here.Store 42. They have the pulut with you know pulut. It's a brown glutinous rice. That one is with curry sauce. So today is not open. That one is recommended by that Motor Mouth from Ipoh. So so this program has been sponsored by Motor Mouth of Ipoh. With his information, I was able to like find all the good food, like say the fish ball noodles and stuff. Yeah.Say hi. Quite cute, huh? So I think that one might be mine or somebody else's, who knows. The weather is still okay lah. It's not too hot, even though it's now around 11:30 a.m. Yo, kilo, kilo lay guy. Kilo lay.
Tango
sam. Chimbo.
Tang 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 tang
tang tang tang tang tang tang tang
tang tang tang tang tang tang tang tang tang tang tang tang
Ah, okay. So the highest, most expensive dish for kway teow is 3 ringgit and 30 cents, which is roughly one US dollars and ten cents. That is one US dollars and ten cents. That one is for the cockles and the egg. When it comes to individual ingredients, like say only with egg or only with cockles, it is 2 ringgit and 70 cents, which is roughly 90 US cents, I guess. So there's a lot of smoke coming out from that place there. So in this small area, do go and try the char kway teow and also the pulut, the curry sauce, wonton mee, and also the kai si sa fan, because I might want to like compare it with the one in Ipoh Old Town or Jalan BJT Mart. Thank you. Hey, oh, you, wow, the lá chiu chiu, thật gì
ấy.
Okay. Hey, coffee shop, thế này cao cao à? Cao cao. So this is the food of that uncle there. So I was like commenting, asking the woman there that why their belacan is a bit different. This is the traditional old style type of belacan. So the procedure is, if you want to like temper or lessen the spiciness of the chili, you put in this one here. This one is acidic. Chili is usually alkalic, so, or if you want your chilies to be a bit more sour, or yeah, more sour, then by all means put or squeeze this lime, or in Cantonese it's called kat chai. So you don't want to eat the seeds because it's bitter. And also there's also an old wives tale in during the olden days that says that if you eat any seed, definitely it will get stuck in your stomach or intestines, and a plant will grow in there, or either that the seed will go into your head, into your brain, and you'll sprout a plant on your bald head. So let's go and try and see. This is the char kway teow. It's around 3 ringgit and 30 cents since it comes with egg and also with cockles here. So let's try it. It's very hot. So, here we are. Thank you.
Ah, 7块钱
for 唔使啦，我自己要够啦，我要走。啊，唔使啦，我唔使啦，我要走。啊，唔使啦，我要走。哦，唔系都系 D24
啊？嗯，啊
D24
D24。你买两盒乜？哇，咁多啊！So
this one is D 啦。
D24。
Are you sure？咁崩 or D？ 你咩名啊？
Auntie Jane.
Auntie Jane. So it's from your own farm?
Yeah. Organic farm.
Organic farm? Wow. Smells good.
Yeah, going back home will be very cheap. Usually we sell $10 one box.
Oh. Can I get it for $10?
Don't want.
Come on. I will buy it for $10.
I will sell you less.
$10 for two? Can I? Can I?
12 la.
10 la. Ah, 10 also. Come on.
12 la.
10. 10. Okay, okay. 11.
Okay.
Ah, okay. Don't be like that lah. I know money, you know. No money one. So this, I'm from Ipoh.
Ipoh. So you are going somewhere else?
I'm going to KL.
Oh, nice to see you.
So this is a nice one, huh? You
say nice one is guaranteed.
It's not kampung one, huh?
We will come again tomorrow.
I won't be around. So thank you. So where's your farm?
In Tapa.
Tapa. Okay. Okay, one day if I come to your ladang house, can take a look.
Can see.
Ah.
You can see. Ah. Organic farm.
Oh really? Ah.
You're from where?
From Ipoh.
Studying.
No.
Journalist.
Something like that. Yeah. So do you want me to come to your place or not?
No,
now. Okay.
I will give you a
makeup.
If I want to invite you, then you can
come. Okay. Got an email only.
Okay.
Okay. This is my phone number. Okay. So YouTube one.
YouTube.
I'm putting this in the YouTube so your face is there already. Sorry.
Oh. This is for YouTube.
Yeah. What? Thank you. Hey. Oh yeah. Auntie Leong, is it? Jane, so this is what D24. Okay, thank you. So the Auntie Jane there sold me this one, two packets of durians for $11. Okay. So now back to the noodles here. Before it gets cold, then it won't be a good review anymore. At least it won't be so heaty lah. You will still away eat the char kway teow after it was presented to you. Then definitely you have a sore throat after that. You can taste the shallots, fried shallots. It's a very, what do you call it? Check on the stuff because I put my bag on. It's very glutinous, so it's very different from the char kway teow that I've normally eaten. Char kway teow here is glutinous and seems to be, it's oily definitely. Char kway teow you need oil, but it's not as oily as other places. That's a good thing. Bean sprouts is crunchy, good. And what about the cockles? Cockles taste like cockles. Slightly salty, not that salty, but slightly salty with a taste hint of blood flavor and also the what cockles taste like. So the chives with the green ones are the chives that lends a herb type of flavor to it when you eat the chives. Nice. And normally people when they see this this lump of stuff here, this is called lard. They fry it and fry the pork skin or whatnot until it becomes crispy, and the residue or the oil, the remainder of the oil is used to cook anything. Like char kway teow as well, to lend it a flavor, because pork oil, pork broth, whatever, gives it a very delicious taste. Sweet and also salty taste. I love to eat the pork lard. Delicious. So the char kway teow here has a very strong fried shallot flavor to it. So I'll try it with chili. So that's why it's different from other places. Other places they don't have the fried shallots like here. Tastes nice with the chili. If you want it to be spicier, you can tell the uncle there that you want it cooked with the chili. Because this char kway teow, I don't think they put a lot of chilies, I don't see it. But if you were in Ipoh or KL, they normally cook it with chilies, and you will see sprinkling of chilies here and there and everywhere. That's the chili flakes. Oh my god, the chili is very spicy. Oh. So this will be my lunch and dinner all in all. Very nice, huh? I'll give this char kway teow 8 out of 10 for being less salty and less oily, and it's a type of a traditional char kway teow. So if you want to eat any of these traditional type of Chinese foods, do venture into the smaller towns like Kampar or in like Bido or Taiping. You want to taste the traditional type of food that has been unbastardized for tens of years already. You go to Ipoh and KL, there are many people who are new at doing this hawker stall. You look at the uncle there, he was like 60-70 years old. So he hasn't changed his style, that's the traditional way. The food stalls that you find in KL or Ipoh, all of them are young chefs opening their stalls. So their foods is more into the modern flavor vibe. Cockles, hopefully no hepatitis. Wow, one big chunk of that, nice. Crunchy. And not only the food that is old style or traditional style, even the payment system is traditional. I haven't paid yet. I think I'm supposed to go there and pay the fellow. So you look back like 20-30 years ago, this is not a uncommon sight where trust was much more of a usual thing. But nowadays, everybody's more materialistic and everything is based on money. So if you go to Ipoh or KL, you have to pay when the food is served to you. So I haven't paid yet, so others have to go there and pay the fellow. So this is the old traditional way of trust. And thank God it's still prevalent in the small towns, which is not tainted by materialism and money yet. This itinerary is in Kampar. I'm on my way from Ipoh to KL. It's a bit sour already with the chilies. It's very spicy. Sour already. So even the chopsticks here, they're not going to dispose of it, they're going to wash it. It's different from the ones that you get in all the new stalls in Ipoh. Those are, they have the disposable type of chopsticks. But these ones here, I don't think it's made of bamboo. I think maybe it's made of good quality bamboo, but this is good stuff. This one they'll wash it and use it again. So about the coffee here, which is your frosty white on top. So I think the, what is she say 160? No, I don't remember. 180? No. Not too bad. It's not so sweet. It's quite nice. It's not bitter. It's not bitter, that's good. If it's too cow or too thick, it will be bitter and won't be nice. But this one is not. It's not sweet and not bitter. That's good. So yesterday I was like hanging out with my buddies Renji and also his wife and also Zari Abdul Muhammad at Starbucks. Coffee Bean in the Jaijasco or Aeon, so, or also known as Kinta Valley Shopping Center. At Starbucks I drank that 13 ringgit small little cup of coffee shake ice blended thingy. I think I tried the what was the name already? The ultimate thingy with all those coffee shredded coffee beans and whatnot, and also caramel and mocha. Well, very expensive, walking with it. I haven't been to a Coffee Bean for like 10 years already. So I was sitting on the chair, chatting, and suddenly Renji said about cosplay in there's a cosplay event in KLCC. I was quite surprised actually, because I did not know that Malaysia has a cosplay event. because we really want to go and film. And all of a sudden I was like, you say about something cosplay, and I asked him, I was very shocked. I would be saying, what the fuck, really? So I'm quite pissed off with the organizers, because they haven't like put out the word out there, and what I mean is advertise it properly, or I don't know, maybe they want it to be a small little thing. So it's happening about tomorrow, Saturday, and also Sunday. There are 2 days. So for the tickets, it's 20 ringgit for a ticket. Yeah, it's 20 ringgit. So for the first time ever, when I started doing this YouTube, which was like say 3, 4, 5 months ago, I'll be paying for an event. So I'll be paying about 20 or 40 ringgit if I want to go the next day, if I can't like cover everything in 3 hours time. So that is why, since yesterday, that I got the news that there is a cosplay event. Now I'm on the road, so I'm in a very very big hurry. So the guy by the name of Renji, he will be there taking photographs and not cosplaying. So I'm a bit excited and also very tired because I don't have enough sleep. Maybe 4 hours. Hopefully I won't die on the road. delicious glutinous char kway teow. Done the traditional way with charcoal and with a man sitting on a stool. I think that is very easy job. But sitting on a stool for many hours for 60 years is quite a big deal. So today I got this this message on my YouTube video involving the unboxing of the Perfect Great Gundam Wing. There's one guy named, I think it is Jason from the Philippines, says asked me to stop, or told me to stop saying the words what the fuck, because it's irritating and annoying. Well, I replied back saying sorry. But actually, I should actually put down the acronym SMD. SMD, which is, there are two ways of it. SMD. Just write down comment SMD. Either I'll be saying sorry my dear, or either that I'll be saying suck my dick, which I wanted to tell the fellow. But I think sorry is the best way to say it. You want to start a flaming war, right? Haters is gonna hate. When people start disliking your videos or liking it, that means you are doing it right. So it's a good meal. So besides that, two packets of this D24 durians, which smells actually very good. So it's 5.50 ringgit each. Be going back to Ipoh and maybe polish. I mean, going back to Gale and polish these babies here. Smells good. For a matter of fact, that the durians like this one here. This durian here, D24 is been around for since the 1990s and 1980s, if I'm not mistaken. And to me, D24, which is again a variant of the durian, which smells like either rotten fish or smelly socks to all those people, like say outside of Malaysia or outside of East or Southeast Asia. Especially the Gaijins or the white people or the Caucasians or whatnot who haven't tried the durians before. D24 to me is the best. There are other numbers as well, definitely. But this is the best. And is the price good for this one, this D24? I think so, because D24 is a very famous brand. It tastes great and the price can be quite expensive as well. And too bad the Auntie Jane did not let me have two of these Tupperware containers for 10 bucks. Instead I compromise and I say okay, 11 bucks. It will be weird to actually go on a journey of 2 hours to KL with two packets of durians. So do come to Kampala. Kampala is a very small town. They have the university here, I think. I'm not sure. It's a small town. It's near the hill there. It should be nice. There should be some trekking areas as well. And you like traditional food, Chinese food that is, with a non-halal flair to it, non-kosher flair to it, or with babi lah, with pork. you come to this place called the Medan Celeria, in the morning, you can try the fish noodles, you can try the char kway teow, you can try whatever the pulut with curry sauce. So one time me and also the kai si sao fan. I'm very curious about the kai si sao fan. I don't know how it would stack up with the Ipoh, Old Town Ipoh's excellent kai si sao fan. I think I'll be in KL for 1 week, about 7 days, because I have to come back to Ipoh for the MRI. I have to scan some part of my body. It's not my dick. That's a hint. It's not my dick. So I need an MRI for. Seriously need a lot of caffeine and a lot of coffee. I'm so sleepy, I might actually fall asleep while I'm on my bike. So if I want to recommend something to you guys out there. On YouTube itself, if you haven't heard of Tachabel D-Cannon, Tachabel as in T-A-C-H-E-B-E-L, fondant asshole cunt, Harry, idiot spelled wrongly, B for bitch, Eve spelled wrong, idiot spelled wrongly, and L for lesbian. Tachabel, D as in dick, cannon. Cannon means it's a looping, it's the same old rhythm all the time, or same old keys. Go and Google Tachabel D Cannon George Harrison. George Harrison, I'm not going to spell the damn thing, but just type in George Harrison. Their search engine or algorithm for YouTube is good enough to, even if you do a typo or incorrect spelling, it still goes to some video involving Tachabel D-Cannon George Harrison version. When it comes to George Harrison, he's a very good pianist. So he did the Tachabel D-Cannon in only with a piano, which is quite unusual. Normally when you do the Tachabel D-Cannon, it involves more than one instrument like violins, harps and whatnot. Because since it's a loop or a cannon, and it repeats rhythm again and again, the Tachabel D-Cannon is really awesome because the instruments keep on adding into the song or the music. And it's very very uplifting. If you hear the piano by this George Harrison, it is very very moving. So do go and check it out. I think you will like it. Whenever I do my comments or replying to the comments, I put on this Tachabel D-Cannon George Harrison version. So when I'm in KL, I will try to go to Shah Alam, which is the service center for Canon, and I had to go there and tell them that my camera does not work. My friend Zairi Abdul Muhammad, he says that don't tell them that the camera fell, because it fell when I was in Penang Swimming Club at Alvin's birthday party, because I was too smashed, too legless, and I tripped my tripod and my Canon A2500 power shot went tumbling down, destroying the lens, or more exactly destroying the spring inside. So Zairi said that I should go there and tell them. One day I turned it on, the lens came out, and suddenly it cannot go back in. And that's the story. And hopefully I'll get a free repair. But I'll have my doubts to getting it done. I will go to Chowkit and see whether they have any new Gundams or not. Then I have to go to Sunway Giza, because I have to return all the magazines, the four magazines that I borrowed from Mr. Famitoy from the Famitoy toy store at Sunway Giza. I don't know whether I can get anything free from Sunway Giza, not in terms of Master Grade Gundam or whatnot, but I think I'll ask and see, see what happens. We would love to get a Kasatria, a high grade one. If they want to give me the Master Grade Sasabi, the old one, I know they have about 2 or 3 boxes there. I don't think I would want it because it's almost the same look as the high grade version of the Sasabi, which I've done already. Because I'm very, very impressed with the Sasabi World Car version, which came out this month itself. That one was awesome, it looks great. The back skirt can actually open up to expose some extra thrusters on the back skirt. The huge back skirt that looks like a lobster's ass. And also, I would like to upload all my videos involving Penang Hunt version 2.0. I'm not going to eat the durians now because I or taste any of them because it's very, very heaty. I don't want to cough a lot. And durians taste better when they are cool, in my opinion, either refrigerated or frozen. It can be like an ice cream. What's the point of buying an ice cream stick durian flavor when you can just buy the durian itself and freeze it? It already tastes like ice cream, and it's natural. And as Auntie Jane or Sister Jane said, that this is organic. Hopefully, whether it's organic or non-organic, I don't care lah. Whether they use fertilizers or use those pesticides, as long as it tastes great, smells great, and feels creamy, that is good enough. But is it as creamy as girls love juice? I wonder. So it's time to pay up, and I'll see you later. I'll do one round around this here, this kampung, just for a short while, and I'll resume my journey to KL. See you in Malaysia, and bye bye. So the food here is good. The char kway teow, got it for free, thank God. I mean, no, I can pay for it, but it's nice of them to actually blunder me. So as usual, that's the mountain, and this is the Medan Selera, and the char kway teow is right about here. This one is the char kway teow, very nice, glutinous and less oily. So let's go and see that. I thought it was a river at first, but it's actually a lake. Because Renji said so, it's a lake. Don't know whether it's man-made or not. Excuse me. It's a bit dirty lah. That's why the rubbish is still here. The longgang system or the drain system feeds into the lake here. That's quite nice, the lake. Can relax around here, sleep as well as the uncle there is doing, or brother. It's here is something like Taiping lah. It always seems like it's going to rain because of the hill there. It's like hugging the cloud is hugging the hill. Well, there's one stretch of greenery there, so that area you can actually climb. I'm not sure, maybe it's possible. There's no trees there, you can walk up. If you have to go through the jungle, oh my god, that would be very difficult, and a lot of mosquitoes. And if you want to avoid being having your blood sucked by the mosquito, you can use a solution, a lemongrass solution, and they will stay away from you. And it smells nice as well, the lemongrass solution, which is was used quite often in that herb farm north of Penang Island itself. That's why the smell of lemongrass is beautiful. I think the way to make this lemongrass insect repellent, a natural insect repellent, I think all you need to do is boil the lemongrass grass for some time until whatever the properties that is important for repelling the mosquito, which I think is the smell itself, will be imparted from the grass to the water. And the boiled solution, you can keep it and spray it on you whenever you go outdoors. It's quite sad that the people have been throwing rubbish there, here and there. This lake is smells a bit funny as well. So I'm just looking for a place to take a piss before I start my journey. It's always good to empty your whatever stuff that holds the urine before beginning my journey. So this is the Medan Selera again. It's quite a big lake. So I think that's about it. Bye bye Kampar and Bido. I'm going to Bido, from Bido there, or Tapa, be going onto the North and South Highway. So yep, Bido, Tapa, North South Highway, going to KL. So yep, that's about it. See you Malaysia. Hopefully you enjoyed my Kampar extravaganza involving the char kway teow and also some pretty girls in the video as well. Go check it out. The video, that is, not the girls, okay? So see you Malaysia and bye bye. And do subscribe if you like whatever I do.